What's going on, everybody? This is Fry. So today we are going to be doing a special tempo green shadow deck. We are running a lot of the brand new event cards. We're running three copies of Spyrus. That'll be good not only at putting a turn one play on the board that you can potentially grow on turn three with the Grow Shroom. It really just helps control your opponent. It's really good at taking out Toxic Waste Imp and things like that. Really, a 2-1 plant card that's amphibious is actually quite a good control card, so we'll try to get some value out of that. This is a tempo deck, meaning you make a play on turn one, maybe. Really, this deck starts on turn two. We are running four copies of Lily of the Valley. Hopefully, can get that out and then make a good turn three play. Following that up with Grow Shroom is obviously amazing. We got the Bananasaurus Rexes on four. We are experimenting with the snake grasses. That's what we are experimenting in this deck. That's why I'm calling it the Tempo Snakes right over there. So that is going to, hopefully we'll be able to get some value. The snake grass card seems a little bit weak. It seems like kind of easy to destroy. All the snake grasses, you know, they all like die to chickening, etc. But hey, you know what? There's going to be some heroes, like hardy heroes especially, that snake grass will probably be pretty good against. We're definitely going to experiment with that. For removal, we do have three copies of the Jumping Bean. Very important to have some hard removal on every deck that bounces a zombie out. Also puts a 3-2 on the board, so it is a real good tempo card. We're also running some plant foods. These work both as a finisher and as a kind of removal card to remove whatever they stick in front of your minions. For the sixth slot, we're running a couple copies of Brainana. It's very good at closing out opponents. There is some synergy here. We do have kind of like a lot of ones and twos that will work maybe well with the Muscle Sprout. Muscle Sprout also could work well with the Snake Grass. We're going to try this deck. This deck definitely has a good curve and in general is actually a lot of very powerful cards. So kind of interested to see what this deck can do. Let's do this. The Sneaky class has gotten really strong. They added that rooster. That's a good card. It's a very good card. Ooh. Ooh. This is better than the Black IP in this matchup. Even though Groan, the Black IP is better, but this survives kind of automatically on turn two. I'm going to ditch this. So I'll just keep both bananas. The banana is so good. Playing it on turn five, especially with Big Chill, it's going to grow both of these. This is so broken. Oh no, I really hope he doesn't get Sumo on two. I'm going to be really sad. Ooh, the mix of Gravedigger is so good. Trickster and a Gravestone is so hard. Tricksters are not good with Super Brains anyway. Ah, please no Gravestone. Yes. Ah, Lily is so tempting here. The problem is it really messes up my tempo if I do the Lily now. If he has Rolling Stone, he passed turn two, so the chances of him having Rolling Stone are decent. He might have Terrify too, which is so hard to play around. I could just go with the 3-2. We'll have a guaranteed... The Lily is a risk, because if we get Rolling Stone, we're messed up. The 3-2 we can't deal with, unless he has like two nibbles or something. Come on. I know some people have pulled Trickster Gravestone off, but when I'm building a deck, I want something that works, you know. You know, it's a deck, it should be a deck that the main part of the deck needs to work 80-90% of the time. Not just like relying on some random thing. Okay, tell you what, I'm happy with the play. Ooh, wow, we can do the Shellery already, actually. I might Lily Shellery. The Shellery works very well with the Lily, actually. Maybe we should put one more Shellery in this deck. Look at this play here. Ah! What are you gonna do, though? Super? Ooh, I wonder if he's gonna... No, if he had Super, he would have done it last turn. It must be Camel Cross. I kind of want to kill this at all costs. So let's do this. This kind of messes up the... Let's just do this. It's a good play. You know, huge cards against the Smash. He doesn't have efficient hard removal. The hard removal is basically Locusorn. So, you know, humongous cards are usually really good against the Smash. This way, Camel Cross does not make this survive. Frenzy also does. What's the point of frenzying there? Dude, it dies anyway. That was... Come on, man. Come on, man. Really? All right. I'm doing it. I'm spamming the scrub emojis. What was that? That was horrible-rific. Banana in... Wow. See, I'm very tempted to freeze this thing instead of playing another card here. Whew, we had a 3-drop. That was a terrible play. I want to freeze it. maybe I'll let these, maybe I'll let these trade. My height line's gonna be clogged, and then I'll just do banana with freeze next turn. Okay, don't know what, it's a play. Developing the banana, yeah, just a banana in one. We have the Lily of the Heights, which, you know, Lily you can play late. It's a card that you can play late and get a huge card on the board, so. What's up, Soul Controller? That's okay. So, it's gonna be banana freeze now. No, I got super, come on, man. Okay, slight change in plans, I guess. If we get another, like, 2-drop. Spartacus! So we could go Lily, Spartacus. We could go Banana Freeze. I could even stick the banana here, and it's probably better to just go offensively right now. Spartacus! Can Spartacus my grass? Okay, so the plays are either banana and freeze. We also could go with the Lily and the Spartacus here. Banana freeze will give us a, it'll have a 5/5 Bananasaurus Rex on the board next turn. This is kind of a good use of the Spartacus. We can really kind of automatically, we can even play both of these next turn if we want. I think we're gonna go with this. It's nice to have the Lily. We're for sure getting another shot out of the Lily right now. I think it's a little bit, this plays a little slower, but I think in the long run, especially if we buff this, this will be fine. If our opponent passes next turn, we'll just bring Nana, you know. Why not? Spartacus! I'm gonna save this. Even if he 50-50 on a Garg or something next turn, we'll probably make this worth saving. See, we can really go put the pedal to the metal here. This is a lot of damage, which usually hits. You know, we can do Bananasaurus Rex, Shellery in the lane. We get the double value. It's 9 out of 10 damage here. And, okay, it was Brainana. It's gonna do something. I mean, it might just be Weed Spray. I think let's go for it. You know, piano is usually not taking this out. Let's go for it. I'm gonna actually blow, I think. Doesn't matter. Yeah, let's use the blow now. Let's use some blow now, guys. It's so good. Double value. This should do it here. If we get the flag, we usually win. Yes. This is usually lethal, because the 9 damage should hit, the 1 should proc the block, and the 2 should win, unless it gets healed, of course. No, wait, the Bananasaurus Rex is going to hit, yeah. Alright, got him. This is so broken. Anyone who told me to take Shellery out of this deck, I should put more Shelleries. I would run 2 more Stealthy Imps. That's how I actually like to play this kind of deck. So I would get rid of the Jesters, unless you have synergy with Firework Zombie or something like that. The Jesters are not that good. So I would take them out for either, if you want Smelly Zombie, something more sustained. If not, just Stealthy Imp. But the rest of the deck looks A-okay. This is so good on turn 2. Ooh, I love this. Which 3 do we go with? These are both good. Okay, do you know what? It's fine. Every once in a while, Infinity can deal with this. It's like with a smoke bomb or something, so it's kind of nice having a backup 3. The Spartacus down the stretch, even on turn 5, will be an okay card. So, it's kind of nice when you have Groshoom. Groshoom's a really powerful 3-drop. Problem is, if for whatever reason you don't have something that survives until turn 3, which, you know, that against Infinity, the Lily's almost always going to survive, which makes it extremely good in this matchup. Infinity's really bad against Lily. But every once in a while, he'll smoke bomb or do something funny. Hopefully he does not start with Super Hair. No. So, it's nice to have a different turn 3 play as well. This will be like a turn 6 play or something. There we go. Plucky from Plucky. No! Bad! Oh, that hurts. It definitely hurts. Wait, if we Groshroom, this will be a 1-2. And then if we Groshroom it next turn. Darn. When are we going to take this out? Maybe we'll take it out with a Spartacus on turn 4 or something. Okay, I think we do this dry. We just don't want to get deadlied. Well, no, if we get deadlied next turn, it's fine, I think. It'll be a trade, and then we'll come with banana. See, if we grow this next turn, it'll have three. It'll have two health. It'll have be a 3-4 against three attack. Fine. It's sadness. I should have put this here just in case we get a snake grass at some point. I'm not really playing into top decking snake grass. I haven't seen the snake grass yet. I think bounce is too slow. This is so good on turn two that we're gonna. There's the snake grass. Oh, I should have put this here. My bad. What's the best no attack team up? It depends in which deck. Chompzilla like needs sweet potato to survive, so in Chompzilla is definitely sweet potato. Otherwise, probably Torchwood. Sunflowers are kind of not that good. What is this going to be, a Jester? Probably Jester. See, if we had a 2-drop, I would just play a 2-drop and blow this thing. In the meantime, this is really bad. Blow this popsicle stand. You know, if this was here, this would change a lot. I really could just go with Sporticus here. This is probably Jester, which will have 3 attack next turn. Let's do this. We can always Sporticus. Well, really don't want this thing growing. What is this going to be? Is this going to destroy? It might be Smelly Zombie. In which case, growing this isn't that good anyway. Okay, let's just do this. Let's see what happens. It's the most solid play, not knowing what this thing is. He's expecting this to be a 1-3-2. Yeah, it's a Jester. The Jester's gonna actually be a 3-2 next turn, which is kind of annoying. This huge card will survive. We're probably gonna go Sporticus blow next turn. Hopefully we can even just blow the... Oh, whatever. Okay, we're doing more damage. We are a little bit faster than our opponent still, but I don't know. This aerobic constructor. Having flaming on 2 would have been so good. There's flaming. See, I almost wish I would have even had this on turn 3. I would have just played this on heights and then blown this thing. And we'll deal with this later. What's going on, Kimi? It's an old Jewish song. Kimi has reminded me of the old Jewish song. Ugh. All right, let's see what happens here. You blow me up. Getting this would be kind of best case scenario. Oh, that was very good though too. All right, let's just do Sporticus. Gosh, I wish I had played the Lily here. We tap deck snake grass. It kind of makes snake grass no good now. You know what? This can't get plumbered. So, we'll just do this. It's fine. Just in case he has Plumber, can take out the 3-2, even though in the long run, the Sporticus is going to be better. Top 5 common cards? I could do that. It's not so hard. I'm going to be spending all my spare time trying to get this rig together, so I don't think I'm going to be having time to be making top 5s, which are extremely... they take a long time to edit. Even though they're short videos. It happens to be my 10-minute videos take way longer for me to actually make, besides for the actual recording time, which I spent a couple hours on these ones streaming. But, you know, I'm streaming anyway, so the 10-minute videos take me like hours to edit. That's just the way it goes. Lily of Venus Flytrap. That will be with Chompzilla. Maybe? Alright. We're obviously way ahead here. Way ahead. I really wish I could have put the snake grass here. The Bananasaurus Rex is fine, but the snake grass is kind of broken. Really, snake grass is not even good in this matchup anyway. Okay. Boop. Wow. Not let these things get off. Looks quite good. Very efficient use. We can go 4-2 next turn, which is just another reason to use the Sporticus instead of the Black IP, for example. Wow! So, we're trading with this. He has 0 brains, so we're good to go. This Infinity is committing a lot, and we're getting some really efficient trades here. I mean, this Jester will do a little damage to us, but if we get super, do we use it here? I think we do. Chickening. Wow, we didn't block. Okay. I'm gonna grow this so it doesn't die to chickening? I think so. Deadly. It dies to deadly. I wonder if that was smart. Snakegrass really isn't bad here. Let's see if he... I don't think he's gonna go for chickening. Chickening doesn't do much anymore. Lily with pair of pairs. It could work. It just, I think you can't have a card that's bad unless it synergizes with exactly one other card in the deck. Pair of pairs is almost always a very, very weak card. It dies to chickening, dies to weeds, it dies to a lot of things very easily. It's usually a very bad card. Unless you're against an opponent with no field clear, which is, you know, not the majority. Mixed up Gravedigger, woo! Okay. We're actually gonna do this. I'm gonna get some of that value. This will make it a water lane minion. Come on, hopefully it's not here. Yes, that's fine. This is a problem anyway, but... Nailed it! Ah, the snake rats are taking over. Plumber this. Nothing's really going... Even if he plumbers this, he's gonna go down to 7 this turn. Ain't looking unless he gets super. Lily Shroom deck. I did try that and it doesn't work. It happens to be mushrooms are really kind of like very second tier when it comes to being in Captain Combustible decks. I've tried a lot of mushrooms in Captain Combustible, and the problem is that Captain Combustible's powers don't work very well with mushrooms. All the other three Kablumi heroes have either rain or, you know, or more spore or some other mushroom power, you know, in nightcaps. when it comes to nightcap, he has like all three. What? It's in the box. Deadly? That would be so good. Wow. No, it was probably just gravestone. Wow, that stinks. Deadly would have been good. Deadly would have cleared these two. Whew, really happy didn't get deadly. Super also would have been good. All right, snake grass value. Ha! Don't mess with the snakes. They're too good for you. We are in extremely good position here. If he passes with more than 4 brains left or just plays like a single gravestone, I'm going to stick the black eyed pea here because then if he chickenings, it'll take this thing out. Something tells me we'll see a trick of the sorts here anyway. Single gravestone, we definitely black eyed pea. If not, let's see here. No, he can't chickening anymore, so let's do this. Very inefficient. Bounce! Where are you gonna bounce? The mix of Gravedigger? Too slow, man. Wow, this fire, this is not a good... That is so slow. We're doing 9 damage as a result of that. Come on, man. And if he decides to plumber one of these, give that man a chickening. What's the most handsome card? Hot date. Hot date. Now we got 11. That's 2. It's still trade, so this is like an easy 2-for-1. Our opponent's gonna have a clear field here, which is quite sad. We can just play these two cards. Snakegrass getting some value here. I'll take it. He blocked extremely well there. Superman! Ah, it's so good against this board. Oh! Swing and a miss! Swing it! If he has chickening in his hand, that would be double Bananasaurus Rex. I think I'll take it. Man, if this man is chickening, we are messed up. I don't think he has it, though. He would have gone for it last turn, I think. It's desperation time. So it's going to be double Bananasaurus Rex just because of how much he committed there. He has, like, Gravestone, I think, in his hands. Pretty sure. He's packing that. One of these will be able to break through. Combined with the Snake Rest in the last lane, should be able to do it. He could gravestone this one. That would save him. And, man, that was actually a pretty good roll here. He's gonna gravestone this, I believe. Wait, did he have plus strength? Oh no, he had plus strength. He used it already. My bad, I'm miscalculating. What's the ugliest card? What's the fuggliest card? I don't know. What's the fuggliest card, guys? Smoke bomb? No! Why would you do that? Now this snake grass is gonna spawn one. Come on, man. Yes! Snake grass value. Yeah. Oh, he did have gravestone. Okay. Ow. Breaks like three teeth on that. Whee! You're stupid now. Congratulations for being stupid. More snake grass. Oh, third banana service rex. I'll take it. Whee! What kind of play was that, dude? He didn't like the one in the water lane. Read the card, man. I know snake grass isn't out, but read the card. This is gonna chomp through. We're doing extremely well here. Come on, man! Ooh, we're seeing some pretty terrible plays by our opponents today. Whee! What's going on, Golden Phoenix? Almost feels like we need a lot of card draw in this deck, like every time. Ooh, chickening top deck. Chickening would be... Well, no, Banana Source Direct would still win despite chickening here. Chickening. The one in lane 2 would still win. Bounce. Chicka-chicka-bounce. Wow, he's got 7 damage on our face. Holy moly. Does he have a shot here? No. Wow, he got us actually down to 2 health here. It's really scary. Infinity's got some mad skills. Whoa, that is pretty scary actually, that bounce. Pretty scary. Alright, we're 2-0. Spirus is not to protect the gravestone. Spirus is a 1 cost, 2 attack minion that can go in the water lane. That's the main freaking part of it. Whoa! We don't keep 2 lilies, but yikes on bikes, this is actually very good in this matchup. This is all extremely good. We can go 2 and then 3 is disgusting. Just disgusting. Why rip Shellery? We'll play the Shellery if we need to, but... Why is Pear Cub amphibious? Bears are good at swimming. Ooh. Even though this is ridiculously good, but taking this out is worth it. This is another reason why you like having 2 ones on the one slot here. It's in case they decide to do some craziness like this. I could bounce it. The problem is it comes back next turn with a vengeance. I mean, he could have Acid Rain or Nibble or something that takes this out, but... The Shellery also ends up being so good here. Okay, if we bounce it... We're really not going to have any opportunity to take out. The Cat Lady is powerful enough that I think this is worth it. We could almost stick the... A Bodhi sending me the deck again. Looks beautiful. Perfect, the Bodhi. Beautiful deck. Yep. Awesome. Why just the one Shellery? I don't know. It was just that we needed one more early game card, another one, and that's how that went. Alright, let's do this. Alright, alright, alright! Acid Rain is so good here. Acid Rain, Acid Rain. This against Snakegrass is good. This is when a card is played here, or enters this lane. When a plant is played here. So the Snakegrass entering this lane will actually, like, be kind of like a machine. What's up, Banana? Thanks, Banana. Ah, oh, got it. Okay. He would have just gone with these two. It's kind of better, this thing being a 2-2 base damage, rather than being a, you know, fresh 0-4 in his hand. So the Gross Shroom is kind of the obvious play here. That's what we're going to go with. They're taking a lot of heat, but we could blow something. It's good just to get rid of this Yeti. It's bouncing in and out. Let's just do this. Nice solid play. The stat combination of these two cards. This combo, the Lily plus the Gross Shroom, is... look at it. It's turn 3. We have a 4-3 and a 3-5 on the board. On turn 3. It's kind of ridiculous. We're really not that far behind here. We're going to block soon. If we just block and get super, that would kind of be best case scenario. Double black IP isn't terrible here. Ah, that rooster, though. The dog! Grows anyway. I think let's just double black IP, clear the field, call the day. We'll end up with a black IP on the thing. On that thing.
wish there was a way to keep this alive. Let's just do this. He's not gonna have it. He already used Galvanize, so I think this is fine. We'll have a full block meter. Yeah, it's alright. Really, the Snakegrass in this matchup is not bad. We could go Snakegrass Blow. We might just see a single target. Really clearing this, clearing the pressure. I mean, he did a good job of clearing our field. We will be left with just the little tiny black IP on the field. Which, you know, it's even a 2-1 black IP against a guy with no field clear is a pretty good threat. He might come in with Rooster. Ooh! Ooh! Man, this might be good next turn. I'm probably going to Snakegrass in 3, I think. Alright, doing pretty well here. I can blow. I think it's going to be Snakegrass Blow. I could go for this play next turn, but this is fine. Acid Rain is fine. This is pretty good. He didn't have another play there. What is he packing? Like Octo Zombies in his hands? Wow, so this Snakegrass against a hero with no field clear. This is really, really good. This is... it's growing! The next time he passes, the banana could actually work pretty well here. And, you know, every time he takes out one of these, it's just going to spawn again. Against Brain Freeze, the Snakegrass is pretty good. It's, you know, if he makes a big play, we're going to go with the Sporticus. If not, we'll just go with Brainana in the water lane, maybe. Even though I might just Brainana in one, so the Snakegrass goes. I guess we'll make a turn one play either way. No! Chicken without a freaking head. Ah, that was actually good. That's pretty good. Blur. I would love to be able to get the lily. We'll get something out of the lily eventually. Man, like right now, Shellery. Right now, Shellery would be so good. Shellery, like right here, I think, or here. Yeah, Shellery here would be so great. Man, I wish Snakegrass had team up. It would be a lot better. This deck is actually very powerful against trick decks. Too bad we haven't been facing many Brainy heroes, but we have, like, all the cards that are anti that. Man, I wish something could happen here. Let's just do this. I think it's the best. The anti-synergy. They work well together. People think, oh, Sporticus Brainana, it's anti-synergetic. It's actually not. No, Acid Rain. Okay, well, it does 2 damage. Ah, Sporticus Valiant. Kiss my grass. Now you can really kiss my grass. Okay, and the block? I'll use Super here if we get it. I'll grow next turn, I believe. Got to grow next turn. Oh! Oh! This is synergy. This is amazing synergy. You know, even growing a Brainana here could do it. This will be 5-6 damage. Booster! Boom. I'm gonna put the pedal to the metal. I mean, I could grow this, but let's just go face. It's gonna get our opponent down to 3, which shouldn't be too difficult to do coming up. We do have a plant food in our deck. And so right now, if we get like any card that just says 2 attack, we'll hopefully be out of lethal. Let's see what he rolls here. Rolled a 1, so we just need any card besides for Lily here. Yes, that does it. That's lethal. I mean, he clogs every lane. Or, I don't know what he can. He can't do anything in this game. Oh, can we do fancy? Ah, yes! Ah, we have 8! Yes! Ha ha! BM value! I'll take it! Let's do it with the wrong one. Let's just win. What's going on? How you doing, Torn Prince? How's it going? Latsadik? Wow. I wish. And that is lethal. BM value! We got the BM. Woo-hoo-hoo! Nailed it! I don't know. It could still be team up. It actually is turning out to be a lot better than we thought. Can I say something in German? Nein! Ich will nicht reden in Deutsch.
That's how much. These are kind of good. I don't need two.
I don't think we grow against him. He just has chop and things. This is so much better. Oh! Oh! That's how you curve it out. I'll take it. Wow, I'll take it. This just in lane, just in the water lane, is going to cause so many problems for this dude. I think we take that out. We'll use this as a defensive card. It works. Again, this is just like a plumber on turn one, rolling stone on turn one for the zombie side. Whatever you call it, you know, solar flare super on turn one. It's just, it removes this threat. That's all we need. Nicht schlecht. I said, not bad in German. This is where he didn't have a turn two play. Well, he's gonna have to beam me up. It's just how that goes. But the Sporticus and the Brainan are gonna be good against the Super Brains. No, he didn't have it. Yikes! We are so far ahead right now. This Sporticus is gonna ruin him. By the way, so is the Black IP. This is disgusting. This is disgusting. The Black IP is so good here. What is this gonna be? Smelly Zombie, I feel like he would have gone with here. We could go with Sporticus. I might just grow this. Don't want, he's not, he can't rocket this anymore. So let's do it like this. This is probably just, I don't know. It's nice to be able to, you know, if this absorbs his chop, I guess it's worth it anyway. And nailed it! Nailed it! Stealthy Imp. That's like what you always play around. And it's so efficient right now. Because he doesn't have any ways of dealing one damage. He'll say he has like Fire Rooster, but we have two good cards on the board right now, and it's just going to become worse for this guy. We can grow this. Hopefully no Fire Rooster. Oh, you think it was, I think it was Electrician. It wouldn't have been bad against Electrician anyway. What is it? He's doing a dry. Doing it dry. Doing it dry. I think let's just grow this. It's not rocketing this turn anyway. Wonder if Chop? No! So I'm gonna miss again. What are you gonna do? Smoke Bomb? It's so inefficient. And it's just gonna make this get bigger, and we're gonna hit him for like. So good. Yay. Woo! Where are you gonna Smoke Bomb it? Here. He's going face. Hallelujah. Hope you're happy. We're doing 12 damage here. That hits. This hits. This will proc the block. The little 2 damage. No, it didn't. Ah. Sadness. The Sporticus is so good here. He can Sporta. Kiss my grass today. Bonus attack, bonus attack. Does not win, because we're just going to kill him if he does that. We're going to hit him with the Sporticus and then hit him with one of our 5 attack guys. This game's over. What could he possibly have here? Okay, so if he bonus attacks and then gets super, it still doesn't help. Fry can speak Deutsch, whatever. What's up, Braxton? Welcome back. Or in this Canadian. I only live in Canada for a couple years, so for like 3 years. So I don't speak Canadian, eh? Yay! Okay, down to 3. Woo! Where are you gonna move it? Here? Okay, I hope you're happy. Oh wait, bonus deck wins? Does bonus deck win here? Oh my gosh! No. Woo! Boink. Whoa, hey! We're actually. Okay, Brainana will hopefully close him out here. Brainana, nana, nana. Down 2-1. Brainana usually wins. Jumping me. It's pretty good. Oh, lethal! Groshroom wins! Yes! Groshroom that messed us up by not proccing that block when we needed it, but that's just guaranteed lethal. The Brainana is real! Wow, he hung in there a lot longer. I thought we would win last turn. But he had some skills. Got that skills. Pizza and fry. I'm competing with pizza and Netflix. Whatever. But we were able to hit 2 in 3,000 because of that. We're 4-0, right? How old am I? I'm 28. Oh, these are all so good. 2, this almost always survives. He has no way of dealing with a 1-3. 3-4, and this is just fine later. I mean, if he plays like, I don't know, Paparazzi or something, then should we go for a 1? Do we ditch this for a 1? I don't know. The Black IP is so good in this matchup. I'm just going to keep it. Aw, Jerry, let's play. Thank you so much. You're so nice. You guys are very nice. YGO? No, bad. Oh, we have blow. Ah, don't mess with my blow. Well, the blow's very inefficient against this guy, but he's playing the right lane. This is probably a decent player. He played in the right lane. He won this against Green Shadow. It's not bad. I mean, you can get like Ninja on one can get like Snowdropped, but then you take out the Snowdrop 2-for-1. So you thought I was 21, really? Did I look that young? People have a hard time guessing my age. Some people think I'm much younger, and some people think I'm older. So I guess that's normal with everyone. People suck at guessing age. What's better, Loudmouth or Groshoom? It depends on the deck. I use Groshoom a lot. I use Groshoom in almost every Mega Gro deck, especially since Lily has come out. Lily and Groshoom is so good. You're going to see it here, hopefully. We're going to go with the... Ooh. See, I almost would want to do this here, so the Snake Grass. We might want to end up Snake Grassing in ground lanes, though. Like here or something. Gosh. See, the Lily, we want to play it in either 2 or 4, just to be able to get Snake Grass value. I mean, if we don't have an answer to this, we don't have to address this. It'd be nice to really get a Spyrus just to get this thing out. Spyrus is so good at taking this card out. Which one do we do it in? This is such a hard decision. Okay, I'm gonna go here. Something tells me the Snake Grass is gonna be best in one of these lanes. Is Vimpire a good card? It is a good card in some situations. The text seems to work in, and if you want a mid-tier deck, you can go with Brain Freeze Imp decks. It's good in that deck, but if you're looking for a top-tier deck that Vimpire works, there's only one deck, and that is Immortisha Trickster decks. You can go just type in Immortisha, fry him up into YouTube. It's basically the only good Immortisha deck I have there, in my opinion, the only good Immortisha deck in the game. So you can go check that out if you want, see some Vimpire value. What is this? Toxic freaking Waste Imp. Darn. Oh, darn. Just get the value already. We don't even have to grow this. Let's just go with this. It's sadness, but... this is better. I mean, there's no point in really growing this thing. It comes with 4-5. She's gonna stick another Imp. Wow, this Imp deck is causing us a problem. So this is really when we need our ones, our Shellery and our Spyrus, which we did not get this game. They would have been useful across the stretch. Even on turn one, they would have been good, so. Rose is good. I'm gonna do Rose tonight, actually, with the 4 Spyruses. I'll hopefully get another Spyrus. If I don't get one by tonight, I guess I'll just spend gems on it. If not, maybe I'll just do Rose tomorrow. We're doing a lot of damage, but... oh, we could use a block at some point here. Man, I don't know what to do. Snake Grass. We might just Snake Grass here. Yeah. I think we're gonna Snake Grass right here. It'll eventually spread like wildfire. That's pretty good. Darn. Okay, well, at least this will still survive, and... he's gonna get rid of the Snake Grass, I mean. That's how that goes. That's good water. Tistaker! Maveti! Niviok! Chitov. I love this stuff. Mayim imtami. I don't know why I'm talking Hebrew right now. Don't ask me. Freezy Freezy! Okay, we're gonna do this. And we're going to Snake Grass. Oh, there's the Shellery. Oof. Okay, I think I'm gonna Snake Grass and Shellery here. Just gotta really weather the storm, and I think we're gonna get to go. We could Jumping Bean if we need to. Gosh, we're taking a lot of heat here.
Oh yeah.
Thank you so much.
Streams. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. That's Jir Light Let's Play. Thank you so much for the donation. Really, really appreciate it. Wow, my Twitch alerts looks really messed up in this one. Man. Darn. So we could go with the bounce, chicka bounce. I think this is more efficient. It gives us a play for next turn as well. I think just stalling this is probably best. Our opponent doesn't have, like, a smoke bomb potential or anything like that this turn. This is fine. It's nice to kill the deadly. It'll give us a second snake grass for next turn. You know, we can always bring Anna next turn if we need to. It's 3 damage. It's hefty. We might have to bring Anna here, which isn't that bad. This has a base damage of 3, right? Yeah, yeah. Hopefully just see pass. That would be awesome. Is Lily OP? Lily is a very, very, very strong card. It's one of the best event cards, if not the best. It's very, very useful. I mean, it hasn't come short at all. Darn. Wildfire? Man, if this is electrician, there's really no way of playing around that for bouncing this. We could go with the bounce. Just play around electrician. I don't know what this is gonna be. It's hard to say. We could play around electrician and bounce this card. I think this is better. This is kind of a weird play. Hurry up! There you go. Hopefully it's not electrician. Strike through. Wow, yeah, we made the right play. We did make the right play. I think we're good here. We're gonna be down to 3, so one more line dancing zombie. Might kill us. Well, in the meantime, we're clearing this field. We've got 2 snake grasses on the field coming in. We're doing 3 damage here. Yes, we rolled a 3. That is so significant. And we got the snake grass value. Clogging up that water lane. The more lanes we can clog here. Ooh! Yes! It's so good to get Spirus just because we can clog another lane with it. Spirus and Brinana are going to be good here. In fact, the Spirus knowing what's in the gravestone might make us be able to really make an efficient play here. The Spirus, you're just getting a 1. A powerful 1. It can do 2 damage. It can clear a field off the board. And knowing what the gravestone here, if our opponent plays a gravestone, we've got to know if it's Surprise Garg or what it is, you know? If he plays just like a single gravestone, we're going to play Spirus in a different lane. Check to see if it's Surprise Garg, and then we'll have an option to play, you know, the Brainana or whatever in this lane or in the other lane. So this is going to be really, really efficient here. Let's see what's in the box. And it's Pogo. Okay. So this is gonna, our opponent's gonna have 3 left. 3 left. We could go with Brainana. Wait, we can do, no, we can only play, I wish I had one more sun would be nice, we could double up. I don't think we want this proccing our block. I think we're gonna grow this one. Smoke bomb for the win? Okay, smoke bomb could win here. It's not likely. Okay, this way if you bounce this, we're just gonna get another snake grass. In the meantime, we, you know, bounce that. And bonus attacks? He's really intent on proccing our block here at Chop. Okay, that's fine. Interesting, he's going face, hallelujah. Okay. It still doesn't win here, because it's 2 and 2, and one of them for sure blocks. Okay, that's good. Wow, super growing. Okay, this is a lot of damage. He used Chop already, too. Wow, actually, block super wins here. Gravestone, no wait, does he have Gravestone? No, doesn't have Gravestone. Super wins. He used Chop already, so it's either got to be super, telepathy, or deadly. I bet it's deadly because he's thinking about it. My guess is deadly. If we didn't use it. I mean, super he would have used. Telepathy he would have used too, so I'm going to assume he has deadly. Brainana is so good here. Brainana is so good here. Come on, man. Brainana is incredible. Brainana is lethal. Oh, what's in the box? It's stealthy. That's useful knowledge.
Oh, we don't. We actually can't bring Nana and something. Okay, I think we're gonna do it like. Again, he has got Deadly and a card in his hand. You know, bouncing this might be good. 4 and 3, maybe? Gosh, I wish I could bring Nana and something. We could bounce this and Sporticus. Just so he doesn't, like, bonus attack doesn't help. Deadly. Okay, this is really weird. But we're doing it like this. This is so strange. This is how we're doing it. We gotta win this turn. This will get make him win next turn if he survives here somehow, but I just don't want him. He's gonna deadly. I don't want him like deadly bonus attacks. If he does that, now we win. He would have actually won if he had exactly Lurch for Lunch in his hand. No, we got him. No! Wait! Oh. Okay. Yes! Sporticus wins! Wow, that was close. There's super. Super would no. Super would not have done it because Sporticus would have killed him anyway. Okay. Whew! Nailed it! The proc the block Sporticus really, really actually play around super there, so that was pretty good. 5-0. Alright. Here we go. We up against Brainstorm. Here we go. This is just considering what we have in our deck, this is pretty good. Okay, well, this Imgur thing is not loading, dude, so. We haven't used plant food yet. Got it back. We lost one and got one. This is not bad. There's so much better cards. Ugh, I just don't want to ditch this and then not get a 2. He's going to run out of small removal. I think we're going to keep this reluctantly. It would be nice to have a 3. We have a lot of 3s in this deck, so hopefully we'll get one. Or even another 2 would be fine. Let's do this. This is fine. If it absorbs a plumber, it'll at least make the 3-2 survive next turn, so. Here we go. Level 16, not scary. Ah! So we'll see if it's a conga or what. This could actually be very useful against a low-level Brainstorm deck, because the Drone Engineer we really want to front, but if it's like Newspaper, we really do not want to front it. Ho-ho-ho! Top deck! Yes! Yes! That's what I'm talking. I'm just doing this. I don't even care. Okay, so in terms of Snake Grass, we already have something in the water lane, so we're going to put this all the way over here. In case we get Snake Grass, we can get this value. Snake Grass is really just terrible against Brainstorm because of Chickening. What is the meta? The meta means what kinds of decks other people are playing. For example, if people are playing a lot of crazy decks, so you want to have more your plant decks have high health. Since the crazy decks are using, you know, good at doing lots of little damage. If the opponents are playing a lot of, seems like the meta, the people are just playing a lot of hardy decks, then you want to go with high attack decks, you know, 3-attack decks, because the hardy class has a hard time dealing with that. So, that's meta 101 for you guys. Gosh. I wonder if we blow here. Hershey blows! We could second Lily if we want. It's disgusting. See, I might just Lily and blow or something. Let's see what happens. If we don't get this one out. Got that one. Okay, so let's just get the value. We'll get a second Lily eventually. Second Lily value. It's a 5-4, it's disgusting. And this trades with this 3-1, so we bounce this little dude. The little dude was actually the best. We don't really want the tennis going back. I don't even know, the blow wasn't even that good there. But we did luck out and get the little dancer, so it worked out just fine. It's banana time. Chickening is not a thing here. Of course. If we really need to, we'll go with the plant food, but that's probably going to be Bananasaurus Rex. I almost would want this to die too, since we have Lily in our hand. That could be an pretty awesome turn 6 play. Falco TK? What does he run so far? You're right. You know, maybe this is Falco TK. It has all the signs so far. It looks kind of like Professor Brain Swarm. Oh! Spyrus! Spyrus Valley's electrician. No! Okay, well, there's nothing we can do about that. It'll kill it. No one cares. This is fine here, just because, again, Snake Grass is a lane 1 Snake Grass. We're gonna shove as many cards to the right as possible. This is okay. This trades. The Electrician is a pretty efficient removal card. I don't think people necessarily see it that way.
It's good in control decks too, because whenever you're running late game, the control deck, electrician works very well with that late game too. I run electricians in my Rust Bowl guard deck, I guess. What's the biggest game-changing card? That's a very hard question to answer. Ooh, this is a 4-4 already, so sadness. Got that sadness value. This is probably lethal. Let's just go for it. Three shots. Should have him here. This will be 5, 5, and 5. As long as he doesn't roll... He needs double threes to survive here. Is Fertilize a Juggernaut good? Yes, absolutely is. I don't do that anymore just because I like playing around. I don't run it Fertilize as much in my Grass Knuckles as I do Grocery Room, but it's a good play. And yep, that was Letho! We're 6-0 with this deck! Got that top tier value with Snakegrass! The Snakegrass have actually been pretty good. There hasn't been an abundance. I don't think we've gotten chickening all day, so the Snakegrass has been efficient. It's kind of good when you can grow one of the Snakegrasses, because then chickening doesn't clear it. It'll clear the other one and you just keep on spawning. It's kind of... Growing Snakegrass, I think, is the key. If you have to, grow like the base one or something like that. All right. Here we go. RNG's a zombie deck. I tried that once. It's not fun. It's really just fun with the Kablumi class. All right, this is fine. This is a little late. I could use a one. This is fine. I mean, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna look for a one. Lily is so good. Okay, this is, changes everything. Especially against Infinity. Infinity has like no answer to Lily, seriously. Whee! No one cares, dude. Do I shoot him in the face here? Oh. Do I shoot him in the face? He's gonna be playing around with the rest of the game, so. In this deck, do I shoot him in the face on turn one? Precision shot on one. This is a fast deck. Usually in faster decks, you sort of want to. You usually end up not having like a lot of extra brains. I think the 5 damage is going to be better than taking out the little 1-1 he's going to eventually use, you know, to clog this lane. I think that's smart. It really depends on the kind of deck. If you're playing a slower deck like a freeze deck, you generally want to hold on to the precision blast. Just be able to deal with the card when they, you know, when you're in the clear, you know, like, turn 6, when you're in, like, the field clear stage of the game. Shallery, I'll take it. Snakegrass. Oh, now where's the Snakegrass going? I think it's going to go on the right side of the field. We have enough things that are going to be going shoving in that thing right now, so. Alright, so fine. What is he doing on 2? I don't even know. Man, this value. Insanity. We could go with the double value with the... It depends how much trouble our Lily gets into right here. Watch him have fireworks next turn. It'll be disgusting. Yeah, he's probably just gonna have fireworks. Goodness. If he plays a gravestone, that's gonna... There's that. That's interesting. Okay, let's get all the value we can here. We can actually grow shroom it. Grow Shroom it, make it survive. It'll trade with this, as opposed to making a strong double play. We don't know this is necessarily going to survive if we Grow Shroom it. It's not a great... I think let's just get as much value as we can out of it right now. Get greedy. This is fine. This is a very good play. Whee! Who told me not to run Shellery in this deck? If only I could put more Shelleries. It's so good. This is disgusting, guys. This is absolutely disgusting. The Shellery could have even gone the back so it doesn't die to, like, chickening or something. But you know what? Chickening's gonna make this a little bit too big to handle. So we can always Sporticus here now. We can also just Bananasaurus Rex here. Well, let's see what he does. We'll react. Pass. What is he gonna do? Cake this? Chickening's not good. Man, I don't know what's gonna happen here. Choose Bananasaurus Rex and call it a day. We could Grow Shroom. We could Grow Shroom this. Ah, do we do it? Something just, it just smells like chickening to, I don't know. And then he draws a card. I don't really want him drawing. Let's just do this. We'll use the Banasaurus Rex when it's more efficient. This will actually prevent... If he chickenings here, it'll actually prevent the 5 damage, but... Well, let's see what happens. I have no idea what this guy's gonna do here. Why, he passed turn 4? Deadly, okay? Yay, hit him in the face. Come on, proc his block. That would be awesome. Yes! Yes! Wow, we're hitting him for 9 here? He doesn't have a second plumber. He would have used it. Oh! Spartacus procking the block! Are you kidding me? Oh, man. The RNG is insane. He's down to 5. Good game, dude. With a 1 block meter, Bananasaurus Rex in our hand. It's whatever. This is disgusting. This is absolutely disgusting. A good game, man. Good game. Yay! It's a bomb. He has no way. I don't think he has a plumber, but he doesn't. He's out of plumbers. We know that. That's game. The 1 block meter. That was cruel and disgusting. Ugh. I'm feeling dirty. We'll do the. Feeling dirty. That's what the dance is in that music video. It's terrible. The music is good and the dancing is really bad. It's the opposite of Upmong Gangnam style. Where the dancing is good and the music is terrible. Yeah, the music is good too. I like Gangnam style. I was kind of into it for a little while. Okay, this is a good hand. This is good against... Well, this works against gravestones. It's kind of... Okay. Come on, Spyrus. 2, 3, 4. The banana is good in this matchup. Kind of never have enough... We have a 2, 3, and a 4, so that's why we can afford to keep the... pretty good card. Again. You know, this really helped us close them out last game. So, rolled a 1. I'll take it. What's up, warning? Guten Tag means a good day to you, my sir. My kind sir. Here we go. Pass. No. No. Where's Spyrus? Ah, oh, this is why we need Spyrus. This is a problem. This is a serious problem. This card. We have 3 cards in our deck that can take this out. That is a major issue. Well, don't want Snakegrass. I shouldn't have put this in the middle because Snakegrass would have. Anyway. Oh, this is not good. This ain't good. Gravestone? He's just gonna stick. This is gonna. Why? Why is he doing that dry? Somebody. Somebody stop me. Oh, this is an efficient play. Whee! He's gonna smoke bomb. It would just be a 2-for-1. Why did he not do that? I don't really understand. Now he just spends a whole extra card on it. I'm so confused. I don't know why he just didn't just do it. Just do it, man. Yay. We're still way ahead. A little bit ahead. Very far from being way ahead. Okay, I think the way we can win here is just by putting the pedal to the metal. So we're going to go with the banana here. I'm actually gonna put it here in case we get Snakegrass. That's still a thing. Man, I almost went Snakegrass right in the water lane, but we'll do this. This is fine. It's a lot of damage. 3 and 2 might be good next turn. Bum ba dum bum bum. Go with that. Fine play. Block grow or something? Well, we're gonna hold whatever we get on the block here. What has he got? Super. It's a way to take out the Bananasaurus Rex. Not super efficient. No pun intended. Okay, we'll keep this. This instead of playing this, we'll grow anyway by 1-1. This becomes 5-5, which is kind of as big as we want it to be. Lily. Ooh, that's harsh. Lily the Spartacus, I guess. I think it's just a race right now. There's no way to deal with this card except for getting Spyrus, which we did not get. Man. If I would know what that is, that would be real good. I think we're going to Lily Spartacus. I think the extra damage is fine for the tricks and all that. Let's do it like this. Do it like that. I could have gone with Muscle Sprout, but... Wait! That's lethal! That's all he had? He didn't have another imp! See, if you're running Toxic Waste Imp and you didn't... I guess it's really just a Gravestone that... Ah, Chop, okay. Wait, no, it's still lethal, though. We still got him. Well, no, this is gonna have to spawn... No, he's gonna have to spawn here now. Hold on. Go in lane one! Lily's gonna be lethal! Come on! No! No! Ah. Okay. If he plays a trick, he loses. This is very good. Oh, man. Oh, man. The final countdown. Ooh, that was good. Da-da-da-dum. Da-da-da-bum-bum. Ah, where's plant food when you need it? You can't play tricks. We'll keep that in mind. I guess we'll go with these two. They'll hit us for four this turn. It's disgusting. I think we grow this just to put one extra pressure on the board. We only have six drops in our hand, which we'll do next turn. Start of tricks. That does not help him at all. This is good that this kills this, because, you know, he can't play tricks. He just can't play tricks, so it's pass. He'll hit us for four. Super wins. No, wait. Do we use super? Yeah, we use super already. We don't really have it. No! Whoa! Wait! Bounce! And bonus attack? No, I forgot about bounce. Or rocket. We're gonna block. Up in here. Sporticus is still a thing. Brainana is really good. Okay, here's the block. Brainana is gonna be a thing next turn. Ooh! I think it's gonna be bounce Brainana next turn. I don't think it could really go any other way. So let's not do this right now. You know, if this was a science zombie, I would play around with like Gadget Scientist or something, but I think it's Brainana bounce. There's not gonna be a better play than that anyway, so. This should do it. This should be lethal. Let's see what we get on the bounce. Getting this would obviously be better. Electrician would win. Electrician actually wins here. Alright. That's fine. Alright, let's see what's in the box. Bounce? The question is, does the Brainana go here now? What could this be? I guess Electrician... You know, Pogo wins. Electrician wins. Is there any point in blocking this? I don't think there is. Let's just do this. Man, I wish I would have gotten this. That would have simplified things a lot. In fact, if I would have gotten this, I probably would have done this anyway, so Electrician wouldn't win. Let's see what's in the box. Nah, got us. Got us! Good game. Ha! Super Brains finally took this deck down, and he was just a... It was the Toxic Waste Imp. Toxic Waste Imp got us. Come on. Oh, I thought I would win that one, too. Oh well, 7-1. Doing pretty well. Pretty well. Up in here. Could really use it too. Getting rid of this against the Smash feels bad, man. This is really not good. The 2-1. This doesn't really help against the Smash. It's very bad against a lot of things. We need a 2. Got it. Okay, this is fine. Muscle Sprout's very good against Smash. Doesn't die raw, and then it grows, and he, you know, it's just like a 3-drop. He has to end up Locust Swarming, usually. Cool. You like the GPS chart. I'm happy people are still using that. I have them basically memorized by now, so I don't use that chart anymore. Every once in a while, I'll whip it out if it's against, like, Brainy Heroes, and there's just too many gravestones, but I hardly ever use it, to be honest. Do I ever regret using this card? Should we try a game where we keep it and see what happens? Usually 5 damage. In this deck really has to win fast. Usually 5 damage, I think, is good. We're always going to do that. Why the Shellery? The Shellery, it provides a little bit of early game removal against heroes that you really need, you know, like Infinity, that you really need, you know, some early game removal against. It also is a team up that can combo very well with Lily. It also protects your big cards if they put something in front of it, like a Deadly. Combos well with you can just stick it in front of your cards and have them survive. And the Flaming Pea is very good here. Let's just make a play. I think the you want a lot of Snake Grasses in this one, so we'll put this in 2. Snake Grass is obviously very good against Smash.
What's the guy's name?
Oh, it's inappropriate. We have to bleep it out. No, wait. No, it's not. It's Poom. It looks like something else, but you can't really tell. It's actually P-O-O-O-O-M. It looks like something else. Okay. So we could grow this. We can also Muscle Sprout. I would love to get Muscle Sprout going, especially against the Smash. Pass? It's going to be just like Weed Spray. Let's do this. Yeah, I would love to get a little one drop here. Getting a Shellery like right now would be so good. Nibble. And what? And Rolling Stone? Still 2-for-1. Come on, man. Yeah. Oh well. I guess Grotion would have been slightly better now. One drop again would be good just for this turn 4 play. Bananasaurus Rex wouldn't be bad either. And got another one of these. Got another one of these. Let's do it again. Developing this against the Smash early, you know, he had a little 2-for-1 combo, which was good for us because it gave us a card advantage. Essentially, we've got 6 to his 5, since he had to use 2 cards on this last turn, but this'll, you know, this'll just grow and grow. he has to use all these cards here. I don't plan on doing Choice Chamber again anytime soon, unless I get a lot of requests for it. It's dead. The game's dead, so it's not good for streaming. When's the new update coming? Nobody knows. I'm still gonna play. I'm gonna grow stream something here. Let's do it like this. You know, Weed Spray. Wait a second. It's gonna be Locust Storm, maybe. I don't know. He's been passing a lot. I guess this is better against Weed Spray. Locust Swarm. This is better against Locust, so we'll play around Locust instead of playing around Weed Spray. Weed Spray here is not terrible. The Locust from the other way would have been pretty terrible. Bong Choy or Tennis Zombie? It happens that he goes with the Weed Spray. Oh well. He might have Locust Swarm too. This is a control Smash deck, so he's passing every turn. Got 3-3. Ooh, Snake Grass. Man, I wish I knew what that was. Ugh, the Snake Grass here is not super effective. I might do it with a 3 next turn. I could go 3-3 right now. That's what I'm gonna do. I don't know what this is. I have no idea what this gravestone is. Landscaper, probably. It's Landscaper. I want this dying. I'm gonna do the snake later. I'm gonna do it like this. Red and Locust Storm this one. So I'm gonna grow that. Yeah, it's Landscaper. Nailed it! So if he can I want him to landscape the 3-3. Now he's gonna make that down to 4 attacks. Not gonna really help him that much. So he's gonna get that. It makes this card, you know, it makes him have to use a whole Locust Storm on the 6-5. As opposed to growing the other one, which, anyway. He has Rolling Stone, okay. He's got a lot of removal. This trade, of course. Not it, unfortunately. Passed him, whatever that was. It wasn't heal. He would have used heal, so it's gotta be. It's probably Frenzy. Galvanize. He probably would have used Galvanize, actually. Okay, this is when this is efficient. I'm gonna do this right here. And this is so good. These snake grass are gonna be around the rest of the game. He has no way of field clearing these things. What's going on? Thanks for the cheer, Steel Clash. Yeah, yo. Yeah. I mean, he has no... this thing's gonna be even a 6-2. He doesn't have a wave dealing 2 damage. This is disgusting. This snake grass is so good in this situation. Come on, man. So great. Flawless, we're gonna... Look at this board. If he removes one, it just keeps spawning. We're just gonna... I mean, this wins right here. The 6 damage is disgusting. Hello, nurse! Goodbye, nurse! See you later, nurse. Enjoy.
Ah, nurse. Inefficient. There you go. He could heal, I guess. No, he didn't get it. He got galvanized. Come on, man. He was getting a frenzy there, too. The efficient nurse, but he got plant booted. Wow. That was harsh. This is Control Smash. This is like a version of the deck we were using yesterday. And, it didn't stand a chance against this. This deck's very good against the Smash. It's just because his only removal is on turn 5, and it's just too slow. You know, if they don't get rid of that first one, they don't have a way of doing multiple 2 damages like chickening. They're kind of messed up. I might want to keep the jumping bean. Just because Z-Mac usually comes eventually with some harsh stuff. Spire Someone isn't bad. It's pretty bad, actually. Well, sometimes it gets rid of. We'll sack it on a tennis champ or something. We have a lot of threes. I think we're just gonna keep the sand. The black IP, you know, it just depends if he's running Rolling Stone, really. I'm gonna do this. I don't think there's a point in holding onto it. He goes with draws that super. It's okay. Come on, this. I got him. That's 4 damage. Kill his card. Pretty good. Right, a little randomness. See, I wanted to know what's in that gravestone now. It's either Kanga, Sumo, or, okay, Snake Grass. He's running Chickening, probably, anyway. Okay, well, Kanga, I don't want to do this for Kanga. Maybe I do. A newspaper I definitely don't want to front, and Sumo, like, I'll let him take his pick. So let's just do this. Snakes can go here. That's fine. What's going on? The swimming banana. That's good for this game. Rolling threes all over the place. Here's the snake, guys. If he commits on turn 4, maybe I'll... Yeah, I don't know. Wow, do we not have a play? We don't have a 3! I held on to all this garbage, and I was hoping we'd get a 3, but... Well, growing this is really good. Actually, there's no way of taking this out. But this is a problem. This is beginning to be a problem. Super would be nice. 4-5, this is so great. Here's banana. I really don't know what we do here. Maybe we just pedal to the metal. Ba-ba-dum-ba! That is sadness. Wow, he took this out. Darn! This was his answer, and he got it. I almost would want a snake grass here, but... We can bounce this next turn, or kill it. Or something. I almost want a snake grass here. We could banana here. Getting the banana going is fine. I'm not so worried about this 3-3 dancer for some weird reason. Let's just do this. What is my name? My in-game name is Fry Him Up. Assuming that's what you're asking. My real name in real life is F. Fry Him. So, it's my Hebrew name at least. Ba-ba-dum! This could be really good. Wherever this goes is going to be fine. Yes! Got it. That's fine. I almost would rather have gotten this one, but oh well. Rest in peace, Black IP. You know, Snakegrass followed by Brainana is not bad. Gosh. Face? Muscle Sprout, Snakegrass. I still have not pulled that combo off. We could go with extra damage. Bouncing something's very inefficient here. We could just go with Snake Grass. It gets plummered a lot, but... I don't know, is Bananasaurus Rex better here? I think it actually is. I think the Brainana's gonna, like, win next turn if we Bananasaurus Rex here. Oh no, not 1 damage! Hopefully he doesn't have a plumber in his hands. I'm gonna be mad if that happens. Boink. Move a plan! Here, I guess. Yeah. Not bad. Really. Okay, clears our field, but it took him a lot of cards to do it. Does he actually have a card advantage right now? How does he have a card advantage? I don't like it. Snakegrass is quite good here. He could have chickening or so many things. Well, if he had a plumber, he would have used it. So it's either chickening or not. Man, I wish I could just do these two. You know, he doesn't have plumber, so he could have chickening. Take the risk. If he doesn't have chickening, this is very good. If he has chickening, it's terrible. That's how that goes. I guess eventually it would have been terrible against chickening anyway, so. Double threes. Two or three, I'll take it. A little small card would be nice. Here we go. We gotta just put this pedal to the metal here. I'm gonna ignore him for a little bit. What's he gonna do here? What is this man gonna do? Let's do this. We didn't get super yet, right? So we got a 50-50. Super and freeze, I believe. Let's just do this. We're just gonna do it to draw a card. It prevents 3 damage too, which is whatever. Bounce Lily or something. Bounce Grow Room, I think, is the play. Well, we could grow this and then plant food. If he doesn't actually front this right now, which he will, he's gotta front it. But we might do it anyway, because he can't take this out on the trick stage. Oh! It's still the right play. Grow Room. And bonus attack. And that makes it have 7, 8, 8 attack. He can't remove this, so he would have to have like another Terrify or something to for this to not work out. Running fail. Dun 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 dun. He's got, you know, the half-empty block meter. This is Z-Max. This is Z-Max Woe. He has no way of dealing with big cards, so if you get this Grow Room here, it's never gonna be enough. Yay, chickening! And we're 9-1. Top tier deck. The value with the Snakegrass. And the Snakegrass, even though they weren't good against Z-Mac with his chickenings, but they've been good in basically every other instance that we've used them. They've been quite good. They've been, you know, they've been game winning in one sense or another, just in terms of getting our board so much farther ahead than our opponent. So 9-1, I'll take it. Let's do some PvP. That's it.